The familiar story of the journey of the Israelites as led by Moses, and the instances when they complained and grumbled against their leader, Moses. So after being led from Egypt by Moses, again, they were led by their leader, right? Who was human, who was not perfect. He led them out of Egypt to a place where there was no water. And there was no provision. Wilderness, which was part of their journey. So it's very convenient to complain, to blame leader, because, you know, it was his responsibility to take care of them. And then the people complained, and sinabi nila, buti pa nung nasa Egypt kami, buti pa doon na lang kami namatay eh. In Egypt, we sat by the pots of meat. That's what they said. We sat by the pots of meat. We had this food and that food. And then they said we ate all that we wanted, which we all know is not true, right? When they were in Egypt, they were slaves. They were in bondage. And right before they left, they were forced into harsher slave labor and forced to even find their own materials for bricks that they were making for Pharaoh. Sipin niyo yun, no? Nagtatrabaho kayo sa isang kumpanya, hindi kayo bibigyan ng materyales, di ba, para gumawa ng mga produkto. Kayo pa maghahanap ng materyales, gagawa kayo ng produkto para maging pag-aari ng amo ninyo. Di ba? That's not exactly the kind of life that you want to go back to, right? Pero ang sinabi nila, buti pa sa Egypt eh. There was a buffet, parang ganun. It wasn't exactly a meat buffet that they were experiencing, that they were enjoying in Egypt. It was bondage. But you see, this is what temptation does. This is what sin does to us. It causes us to be blind. It deceives us. What the Israelites were saying and thinking were not the truth. It was not the truth. It was, you know, they were delusional. It was a delusion. And that's what sin does and temptation does. It hides the ugly truth of our bondage to sin and to the ways of the world, which is what Egypt represents and symbolizes. And it presents it in attractive packaging. Pinapaganda ng demonyo yung itsura ng slavery, itsura ng bondage natin sa kasalanan. At nabubulagan tayo. Yun ang ginagawa ng kasalanan at ng temptation. And it keeps us from seeing the blessing of God's deliverance and the fulfillment of His future promises. Tandaan natin palagi, no? Let us guard our hearts against that. That's what temptation does. Again, binubulag tayo. Binubulag tayo, dinideceive tayo. Ang pinapakita sa atin, hindi, itong pinanggalingan mo, yung dating buhay mo. Ang ganda niyan, di ba? Ang ganda niyan, di ba? Meron kang ganito, may bisyo ka, tapos umaasenso ka dahil ganito. Sa mga panluloko mo, o sa mga pagsisinungaling, o sa mga wicked ways. And it makes us think that kind of life of bondage to sin and the wrong ways is better than God delivering us from sin and death. And it blinds us, it keeps us from seeing that God is not even done with us. We may not be seeing right now the fullness of God's promise. We may still be in the wilderness. We may still not be in the promised land. But temptation blinds us from the hope, blinds us to the hope of God's promise being fulfilled in us, which is sure to happen. Kaya lang, syempre, may dadaanan tayong journey. Dadaan muna tayo sa wilderness, di ba? Bago tayo makarating doon. 2-3 weeks ago, we went through Holy Week. Holy Week is the way to Easter. The cross is the only way to resurrection. You cannot rise from the dead if you don't die first. Tama? Hindi ka pwedeng mabuhay muli kung hindi ka muna namatay. Di ba? Hindi mo na kailangan mabuhay muli. Buhay ka na eh. Hindi ka na namatay eh. Di ba? So, we have to go through that. And that temptation to think that way becomes stronger when we encounter trials and hardship. Uy, bakit walang tubig dito? Bakit walang pagkain? Bakit wala pa tayo dito sa inaasam natin? Bakit hindi pa nangyayari ito? Bakit ganito ang nangyayari instead of this and that? And then we find ourselves complaining. And you know what? Not only are we blinded to the truth and the beauty of God's promises, it does that to us. It makes us complain when we encounter difficulty and causes us to look for someone to blame. At kadalasan, syempre, ang sisisi natin, yung leader. Tama? As in the case of Moses and the Israelites. Palaging ganun eh. It's a given. Ikaw kasi. Dito mo kami dinala eh. Walang tubig dito, walang pagkain dito. Eh, alam ba ni Moses yun? Hindi niya alam, tao rin yan. Eh. I mean, they all came from Egypt. They didn't have ways at that time. Hindi alam ni Moses, saan ba merong ano? Saan ba merong McDonald's? Din tayo dumaan. Hindi niya alam din yung daan eh. No? He was himself being led by God. And part of leading the way is going through what is necessary to build our character, to enrich our faith, to strengthen us. Kasi kung di tayo dadaan dun, hindi tayo lalakas. Hindi tayo mananalig sa Panginoon. Di ba? That's part of our journey. It causes us to look for someone to blame, usually the leaders. And when that happens, we will be convinced that we are right and they are wrong. Sabi ni Patriarch, ang deception, isang characteristic ng deception is hindi mo alam na deceived ka. Di ba? Kaya nga deception, hindi mo alam na deceived ka. And he also said, tatawa kami ito, he shared this in one of our clergy conferences. When that happens, you think you're right and your leader is wrong, he said, you will not be alone in that opinion. Sabi niya gano'n, hindi ka mag-iisa. Meron kang kasama. Yung mga demonyo, yung mga evil spirits, sabi niya gano'n, kasama mo sila, agree sila sa'yo, sabi nila sa'yo, amen, brother, tama ka, mali sila. But you know what? Like I said, leaders are human beings as well. They can be wrong. They're sometimes wrong. They're many times wrong, especially in my case, right? But sometimes we're right and others are wrong, especially leaders. You know when we will know that we're right and leaders are wrong? We have guidelines for that. They're called the canons. That's why they're there, the canons. But let us guard our hearts. Guard our hearts and echo the prayer of St. Paul, which said, I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened. Hindi kayo ma-deceive. Eyes of your heart may be enlightened, that you may know the hope of His calling, the glorious riches of His inheritance, and the surpassing greatness of His power toward those who believe. We are in the season of Easter. Let us always remember, let's be always reminded of what Easter is about. We, dying with Jesus and rising with Him again. Sabi ni St. Paul, I've been crucified with Christ. The life I now live, it is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. Right? I died. I've been crucified with Him. Now I'm raised from the dead. The life I live now, it is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. The life I live now, I live for Him who died for me. Diba? We've been crucified with Christ. We died with Him. And we have risen with Him. And St. Paul continues to say, or also says, in another letter, the Colossians, he says, if you have been raised with Christ, if you have been resurrected with Christ, you understand the meaning of Easter, you've been raised with Christ, then set your mind on things above where Christ is. Look at Him. See Him. Make Him your pattern, your model. He who submitted to His Father, who humbled Himself and obeyed to the point of death. We need to die. Our pride needs to die. Our arrogance and the thinking that we're always right needs to die. So that then we can be resurrected with Christ. Because like I said, only by dying can we be raised up, right? But we need to die. And when God raises us up, we will not rise up to the old life, but to a new life. Now with eyes that see, right? Now with the obedience of Christ. Let us remember that. That's the meaning of Easter. And also the way it is in the kingdom of our God.